The UN is warning of another potential military crackdown in Myanmar, with fears it could be similar in size and scale to the one in 2017, which forced more than 700,000 Rohingya Muslims to flee the country. Only this time, the Rohingya are not the targets. The country's Buddhists are being attacked. And it seems the reason for the military offensive this time is the same as it was last time, an attack on Myanmar police. The government says 13 officers have been killed by Buddhist fighters from the Arakan army. The response from the military has been swift and harsh, with reports of an unprecedented level of fighting in the troubled Rakhine state. Not only is that the same area where the Rohingya crisis began in August 2017, but the government is using similar language to what was heard back then, with talk of clearance operations. Knut Osby is a UN humanitarian coordinator in Myanmar, and he is with us now from Yangon. So thank you for your time. What exactly do you know at this point about Myanmar's military option, which the government says is targeting this Buddhist insurgency, and an army which they say is well-armed and 7,000 fighters strong?
Yes, thank you for having me. This attacks that happened on the 4th of January that you referred to was an unprecedented escalation from the Arakan army, and I would like to express my sympathies to the families of those who were killed then. Now, that has led to an escalation in military presence in Rakhine State, and we are worried that of the fighting that might come out of this escalation.
Yeah, what are you seeing in terms of sort of troop movements and essentially the level of military deployment in the region, which would suggest that something more serious is in the works?
Yes, there has been a number of government statements saying that the insurgents should be crushed and that these military operations would be large. And there has been a large number of troops moved into the area. The situation is not entirely clear. We do not know exactly where the troops are deployed. And the large-scale fighting has not started yet. We are, of course, hoping that there will be some peaceful solution to this, because in a large-scale military action, there's a big risk for civilians. Our main concern is the civilian population.
Back in August 2017, an attack on police outposts was used as a pretext for the start of that military operation against the Rohingya Muslims. The UN later described that as a textbook example of genocide. Is it just coincidence that the same pretext, the same incident has happened again? And there is now what appears to be a military operation targeting another minority within Myanmar?
We don't know exactly the reason that there were escalated and more coordinated attacks from Arakan army. I am worried about the similarity in the types of response, because we know the severity of what happened to the civilian population last time. We hope, of course, that this will not escalate to a very large extent, but we need to be prepared for the possibility that there will be a new humanitarian crisis on top of the existing one.
So we shall leave it there, but very much appreciative of your time and the update. Knut Osby, the UN humanitarian coordinator in Myanmar, with us there from Yangon. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.